Joe Streeter for British Boxers. My pleasure to meet again. We finally meet again. Wayne Smith, Golden Gloves ABC. How you doing? You okay?
I'm good, my man. Are you good?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you. I'm good. Good show tonight. Really.
Yeah, it's been good. Been good. A few of the new prospects done really well. Two Connors done good. Yeah, good.
So, yeah, the stoppage
Connor Burton was beautiful.
Yeah.
Connor Ward, great. Connor Burton.
Yeah.
Great, qualified.
And we spoke a bit last time out about Marcel. How's he doing?
He's doing well. He's got a date, just a tick over on the 14th of March, yeah, he's got to take over there, so see what comes from that. I just want to keep him busy, because last year, like, he had one fight and then boxed for the English title, and then boxed 8 weeks later, he boxed for the British title. And as you know, it's an ideal preparation for a British title, especially against Sonny Edwards, who obviously is well-ranked, he's a very talented kid, nice lad as well. So, it wasn't ideal preparation, so this year we've got a plan to keep him busy, keep Marcel busy, get him out as much as possible. Also, just we've got a plan for him. You know, he's already proved he can do it at the highest level. He likes the lights, he likes the show business, and you know, I've always believed in him since he was a kid that he can do it. It's now he believes in himself now, and that was the only problem missing with him. There was something missing with Marcel, but now, as everyone's seen, he's touching distance away from what he can actually do.
But even in defeat against Sonny Edwards, is obviously he dropped him, uh-huh. But also his stock really rose. You know.
Yeah, his stock rose because obviously when he was an amateur, he only got beat by the best, and he always gave weight away. You know, like Sir Peter McGrail, who's going to the Olympics, he got beat by him. He got beat by Lucian Reed, who's boxing tonight for the British title.
Yep.
And he also got beat by Callum French. All top quality fighters.
Lucian Reed's quite a bit heavier.
Yeah, well, that was the thing with Marcel. He was always giving weight away when he was an amateur. He was like 57kg, 56kg, but he was always weighing in a little bit heavier than the lighter weight. He couldn't make the 52, he couldn't make it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But now he's on everything. Now he just believes, he's just come on so much, he's just mentally on it, you know. And you know, he's just, with that last performance, you know, we know where we went right and we know where we went wrong. And you know, we did, obviously we didn't get the win, but as you said, his stock went up.
Yeah.
But we need to win.
Yeah.
We need to win.
And where is that on March 14th, by the way?
It's just in the Olympia, in Liverpool, Steve Wood Show, VIP show. So he was boxing there. We look for the likes of Tommy Frank for the Commonwealth. You know, there's
really good fight.
Yeah, good fight there. We've been offered other fights. So, but likes of Tommy Frank, he's had that title for 12 months.
Yeah.
Next month. So surely they're going to take off.
He has got an
IBO. Yeah, he advertised today. He's got an IBO world title. So whether that sort of title's recognised, you know, we're going to get an IBO if it's going to be the likes of Saudi. Then yeah, you go for the money and you'll do it for the money there. But IBO basically is what are you getting out of IBO? You know, it's a stepping stone. But we had Kasim Kademi, who was supposed to be our mandatory for his English title, but that fell through. There was talks about Craig Derbyshire again, but what you're putting this fight in Craig Derbyshire because you beat him twice already,
yeah.
Comfortably. There's you know, Craig Derbyshire is a journeyman. No disrespect to Craig Derbyshire, he's a lovely kid. But, you know, what's the point of going backwards for us? Kasim Kademi being promised that fight coming up for the WBO, European on a lot of things. So hopefully we've got that, so we'll be promised that. So he's injured at present, apparently, so when he's better, we'll have that.
Yeah.
Do you know, so. Onwards and upwards.
We spoke a little bit before about obviously the big fight tonight, but the big fight next weekend as well. The big fights next weekend and Califi against Chocolatito and Jay Harris against Cesar Martinez. Both tremendous.
Great, Bill. Great, Bill. I'm gutted I'm not gonna go there because that is a fantastic night of boxing. Do you know, Garcia Vargas. It's just a great night of boxing.
Yeah.
And like, so, you know, the little weights, when we were talking last time about the little weights are doing it proper. You know, Sonny Edwards Charlie Edwards, big names, Jay Harris, well, the Steel City gym are flying, aren't they? And all the little ones, I believe. What's the name? His British title flyweights just fell through something.
Gamal, your fight.
But yeah, the smaller divisions are flying, and it's better boxing, it's quality boxing, and
yeah, really
people don't. Yeah, it's good. You see what you that show next week. You know, if Chocolatito can, he's one of my all-time favourites.
Yeah.
If he can do what, if he's a little bit, I think he. Yeah, he's on that in that hard night's work there.
Still, it just needs to be a shade of the old Chocolatito.
Yeah, it's a shade. Yeah, it could be a bad night for him, but hopefully, you know, we win and we fly the flag for the country, you know. But it's going to be a hard task. Also, Jay Harris, that's a very, very hard task. It's got to be realistic, haven't you? You know what I mean? You know, but he's getting over there, they're doing it.
I think he's in a situation as well, not entirely similar to Marcel. Obviously, it's magnified, but if he goes and he puts on a show, he shows he can hang at that level.
Yeah.
That's only a good thing for him, right?
Yeah, of course. It's a win-win fight. You can't at that level. You can't tear that fight down, can you?
No.
Come on. You know, ordinarily, I think I spoke to you last time. We wouldn't have talked to Marcel fighting Sonny so soon. You know, as I said, it wasn't ideal preparation. We wouldn't have took it too soon, but he'd been beat by Brad Fiedel, so. There was nothing to lose. It was a win-win.
Yeah.
As you say, Sonny Edwards, top of the pile. It was a win-win, and also, you know, he done really well. He done really, really well. Shocked Sonny.
Yeah.
Although I think Sonny knew what he was on through the amateurs and whatnot, but I think he overlooked him a little bit. But I know for a fact Marcel works properly, and we stick to the plan, get some good fights in the next 12 months. You know. Marcel will be his mandatory, he's going to have to fight him, he's going to have to fight him again or give the belt up.
That's a rematch that Marcel really wants, right?
Yeah, we'll have that, Well, he can pick his next one, can't he? And then he's got to fight, fight his mandatory. With Marcel being English champion already, I think he's his mandatory, but there's no one jumping off to fight Sonny, come on, let's have it right. There's no one, he was calling everyone out all last year, no one will fight him.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? We was prepared to fight him straight away. The fight got offered, we said yeah, straight away. The only reason it got knocked back was because Marcel hadn't done over six rounds, and the board wouldn't pass it, and that was in the summer. He'd done the 10 rounds, and we fought 8 weeks later. I'd say not ideal preparation, no excuses, but Marcel's stock's risen. He's in a good place. He's in a proper mentally, physically, he's in a good place, and he knows what he wants out of boxing now. Way before, he was a bit like going on these small shows, selling tickets. It's just like it's a pain in the ass, isn't it? You know, it's like, you know, people don't really look at boxing. They can't see behind the scenes. They only see the end product in the ring, but they don't really see the training, and when the kids get a fight date and these small shows, they've got to sell the tickets, and you know, the runarounds from nights, you know, then they make no wages from it. And, you know, everyone thinks, and then they've got to pay for the license once a year. No, it's a hard game, it's a proper hard game, do you know what I mean? But people don't look at that side, you know what I mean? There should be something where, you know, boxers need. They need amending, number one, for getting in the ring. But like, they don't get enough respect, I don't think. People don't see how hard they grind and graft, you know, making that weight, seeing people suffer, you know, and, you know, they have to give up everything, don't they? You know, never mind me as a coach, I give everything up. And I speak for every coach. We give everything up, but like, the likes of these boxers, you know, they're in the prime of their lives, and, you know, they're running around training them, you know. Obviously, some of them can get through and do well, but most of them don't make it anyway, do they? You know
and the sacrifices they get.
Yeah, and that's how you get good kids going on the road then.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? But, you know, it's a shame, isn't it?
Yeah.
But there you go.
It's an interesting one, you know. I've been to a few shows now, and at what point do you just have to roll the dice and say, you know, I'm not selling the tickets, or I'm not getting the fights that I want. I'm just going to have to maybe take a few losses, take a bit of a chance and go on the road.
Well, that's down to the individual itself. It's like, if they haven't got a sponsor, if they haven't got no one who can, if they're not a big ticket seller, I know loads of kids who are good, really talented kids, but they can't sell a ticket. You know, there's a kid there, I'm not going to mention his name, but he's a proper talented kid. He couldn't sell 20 tickets. You know, so he's been inactive for what, nearly 2 years. What's he going to do? I said, go on the road. Go on the road and, you know, maybe five fights down. And then promote yourself for five fights.
Yeah.
Because if you want to be a boxer and you want to do that, losses are none. Who cares about losses? You know, you get like these kids, you just finish out. You're on the GB setup, you're on the WSB fighting five rounds. And then they suddenly, all of a sudden, want to turn pro, drop down to four rounds, fighting journeyman. And where's the sense in that?
Yeah.
You know, you're fighting the best in the world, WSB, and then you just turn over. It's crazy. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? The boxing game's mad.
I see people doing it for like the first 2 or 3 years of their career, and you're just thinking,
You know, if you box for your country, and you've boxed on that GB squad, they do everything properly. If you've got all around the world boxing the best in the world, obviously turn pro. Yeah, why do you have to go back to four rounds after boxing five rounds? Go back to four rounds and fighting lower level opponents, where they obviously they'll pull your
wasting.
The wasting, you know, if you box for your country and you've boxed on that GB squad, they do everything properly. If you've got all around the world boxing the best in the world, obviously turn pro. Yeah, why do you have to go back to four rounds after boxing five rounds? Go back to four rounds and fighting lower level opponents, where they obviously they'll pull your talent down and your ability down to their level sometimes. In a lot of cases, you know, the better the opponent, the better you box yourself, but. It's just, boxing is mad. It's mad.
It's interesting, we've seen that trend be broken a couple of times. I think Lomachenko being the obvious example, but you can't really point to Lomachenko because it's special. But Joe Joyce as well, I think he turned pro and he boxed Ian Lewisham in his first fight, and it was like, this is not a debut opponent, you know?
Yeah.
He's been boxing better people.
Of course, so why? They should just do it. Because you know what, the kid in the public. You go to these big shows and you know what round they're going to win, who's going to win. You know exactly what's going to happen. So why not get the 50-50 fights and let's go.
Yeah.
You know, some of the promoters now are doing 50-50 fights and, you know, they're getting the crowds in. And, you know, so what if you get beat? You get beat. It's not the end of the world. Taking a loss, take an L for what? So fight someone who's top of the pile. You know, to me it makes sense rather than get all the pressure on you to fight some journeyman. The journeyman has to win, or he's getting his license took off him. So he'll give it to you like that. And you know, in my experience with boxers fighting journeymen, they seem to lower the. They do lower, like I said before, they lower themselves to that to their level, and they say, oh, it's about learning the trade. It's about you learn your trade in the gym. You learn your trade. They spar all the time. Yeah. You know, everyone's got a different outlook, a different opinion, a different outlook. My opinion is, you know, you learn your trade in the gym. If you've had a massive amateur career, you don't need to have 10 or 15 fights before you fight for a title, do you? Do you know what I mean? You know, a couple, yeah. You know, a couple of six-rounders, eight-rounders, yeah, of course. Against 50-50 good lads, not lower level. It's pointless.
I think that's what we've seen a bit of it tonight with the good balance of journeyman, but you know they'll come back at you and they've been willing to exchange.
Yeah,
they've not made it an easy night's work for the home.
No, well, that's where you have to amend Kevin Marie's the matchmaker tonight, and you know he's done really well. The show's been 50-50, and like it's been a really good show. You know what I mean? So Mark Heffernan's next. So you know, see Mark Heffernan on Small Arms. It's a good show. It's good, and it's good that Mark's willing to come on these. He's not no big superstar. He is, but you know, he wants to take over. He wants to fight. So let's get out and fight instead of waiting for these big shows. You know what happened in every blue moon. You know why wait around? Like, you know, you want to fight? Get out there and fight. Do you know what I mean?
When the big opportunity.
When the opportunity comes around, you're there. You're equipped. Yeah. You're equipped then. You know what I mean? So.
One more, mate. Just how are things at Golden Gloves? All good.
All good. All good. Very good. Very good. We've got a thriving new gym. We've got some great talented kids. We've got a couple turning over next year. Well, this year, sorry. Got a couple more turning over this year. So just onwards and upwards for Golden Gloves. As I say, Marcel's, you know, he should be this time next year. He'll have that strap round his waist, believe you me.
How good is it for the other kids in the gym, especially the younger kids, to be around Marcel and to be...
It's great because he gets in with all the young kids. He gets in and does rounds and rounds with all the young kids. Do you know what I mean? And, you know, he speaks to them, as you know, is well documented that he suffered from a little bit of problem with depression. And, you know, he speaks openly to the kids about it. And if he can speak like that to them, it's like, they've got no reason to hide behind the doors and say, well, this Marcel, he's a champ. If he can speak about it, I can talk about it. So, you know, it was good that he done that because there's a lot of people suffering in silence, you know what I mean? And, you know, it's part and parcel. People, it's very common these days in a depression. I think everyone's suffered a little bit somewhere along the time and someone's had depression, but it's being open and coming out and speaking about it, do you know what I mean? So.
Well, thanks ever so much.
No problem.
Enjoy the rest of your night.
No problem.
Tom, man, thank you.